Okay, moving on to the next team in the SEC that I will be going over today. That is going to be the team that I'm going to predict to come in sixth place. And I know this is going to be a pick that surprises a lot of people because most other people are higher on this team than I am. And that is Mike White and the Florida Gators. And I'll start off by saying this. I think if you look at the Florida Gators roster on paper, you can make the argument that they have just as much talent as Tennessee, the team I have coming in first place in this SEC. I think an argument could be made that they have similar amount of talent to Kentucky, who I've finishing in second place in the SEC. So now, you guys are going to ask me, Zach, if you just said on paper, Florida's talent is just on par with those two squads, how are you going to have them in sixth? And I'll give you a very simple answer, is that last year, I kind of made the same mistake. I actually predicted Florida to win the SEC last year. I was very high on this team and the way they were built. They had one of the best and very well put together roster in college basketball. They had Kerry Blackshear as a center. They had Andrew Nembhard as a point guard. They had wings like Noah Locke and Scotty Lewis and Trey Mann and Keontae Johnson that I all thought were able to make a real impact. And I'm telling you, man, Florida was about to be one of my teams that I was going to pick to win the national championship before the season started. But boy, was I wrong. Because Mike White, the pressure's on, man. And I gotta be honest with you, I watched a lot of Florida last year, and the more I watched Florida, the less impressed I was with Mike White. I do think last season, Florida was not only the most disappointing team in the SEC, but they were the most disappointing team in college basketball. They were picked sixth in the AP preseason top 25, and I once again was ready to label them as national title contenders. And I think that last year, after the amount of talent that they had, I cannot pick Florida to be anything better than a top 25 team at best, because once again, I just have to see it first. They had so much talent last year. I was so high on them, and unfortunately, Mike White and his squad was not able to come through. Now, there are some Florida fans that are saying this year's different. Andrew Nembhard transfers to Gonzaga. I'll be honest, I wasn't a huge fan of his game, especially at Florida last year. He was very disappointing, but I do think he's going to be the kind of guy where he could thrive at Gonzaga playing for a real coach like Mark Few, who knows how to get the best out of his players. And I'm not trying to bash Mike White. Like, I don't think he's an awful coach. The comparison for Mike White that I'll make is Shaka Smart. As a matter of fact, my guy Aaron Torres calls him Deep South Shaka Smart. And I agree with that nickname, man. They're very, very similar because each year, each of them is able to bring in a lot of talent on the recruiting trail. You guys know Florida is a school where you could win there, especially with all of the resources that they have. And unfortunately, Mike White has really not been able to do that since his team, very surprisingly, was able to make the Elite Eight, excuse me, in 2017. Really, since that season, though, I do think Florida has been disappointing. And they lose Nembhard and Blackshear, but they do bring everyone back. Plus, they add some talent as well. Florida will be bringing back Trey Mann, the 6'5 sophomore. He only averaged 5-2 last year. He was very disappointing. I think most Florida fans actually did expect a lot out of him. Another guy they bring back that I think was kind of disappointing last year was Noah Locke, the 6'3 junior. He averaged 10.5 rebounds last year. He is known for being that sniper of a three-point shooter, and last year he was not able to get that three-point shot to fall consistently. 2 years ago, he was able to, so that is a concern for Florida. I think in order for them to hit their ceiling, he is going to be a guy that really gets going. The one guy, though, I think, that if you're a Florida Gator fan, and you ask me, Zach, who is the one player that you think has to play well in order for us to succeed this season? My answer to that question would be Scotty Lewis, the 6'5 sophomore. He averaged 8.5 points and 3.5 rebounds per game last year. And to be honest, he was one of the main reasons why going into last season, I was so high on Florida. And there are a lot of people saying that this is the year where he just absolutely explodes. And if he does, that's fine. And he was a member of the SEC All-Freshman team, And that was with the fact that he was kind of a low usage player, but he was highly efficient. He did knock down 43.6% of his three-point tries in conference play, and he's very good on the defensive side of the ball with all of his versatility. He's able to block shots and force turnovers with the best of them, and his athleticism is really good. They also bring back Keontae Johnson, who had a really nice season last year, and I feel like over the last two seasons, if you watch Florida basketball, Keontae Johnson has been one of the only players who each and every day shows up and plays hard for this Florida team. I feel like there hasn't really been a Florida Gator game over the last two seasons that I've watched where Keontae Johnson just isn't in the middle of things, getting his hands dirty and providing his team with extra opportunities to win. And he was the only Gator on the SEC's first team last year, and he had a great season. He ranked second in the league of the SEC in offensive rating, ranked 8th in steal rate, and 3rd in defensive rebounding percentage. And it's nearly impossible to stop him when he gets momentum downhill driving the ball. He could shoot it a little bit as well. And I do think he's going to be an NBA player. I'm a big fan of his game. If there's anyone on Florida that I really like, it is him. The other guy on Florida I think that could be pretty good next season is going to be the guy who takes Kerry Blackshear's spot and is starting at center. That's Omar Payne, who was really good last year, but in limited minutes, posting high rebounding rates and, more importantly, a high block rate. He takes up space in the paint with his long arms and is good enough around the basket not to be a liability offensively, and Florida also has a lot of depth at that center position as well. But here's the thing. Mike White needs to have a big season for Florida. If Florida comes close to missing the NCAA tournament, to be honest, I have to let this guy go, man. It may be that time. Because at a school like Florida, when you bring in talented team after talented team, it's fine to make the NCAA tournament, but just the way Florida has looked via the eye test over the last couple years, I don't think you could sit there with a straight face and tell me that you feel good about the direction of where exactly this Florida Gator team is going. I mean, look at Florida's schedule last year. If you look at their schedule up close, it wasn't great. They didn't have that many games where they won, and it was like, all right, I feel really good about this Florida Gator team. If you remember, they had a big lead at home late in the season last year in a game against Kentucky, and somehow, some way, they blew it. They lost on the road to Tennessee. That was the team that they were better than. Lost on the road to Kentucky. Lost on the road to Ole Miss by 17. Lost at home to Mississippi State. Lost to LSU on the road. Lost to Missouri on the road. Lost to Utah State. Lost to UConn. Lost to Florida State at home by 12, and I remember watching that game vividly. It wasn't close. So I do think Mike White is going to have to really just get his team to buy in more. It's that simple. The other concern I have for Florida is their point guard spot. And right now, most projections are starting Trey Mann as the starting point guard, but I gotta be honest with you. I think Florida last year was very good when Quez Glover, the 5'11 sophomore this year, he averaged 4.4 points per game, one rebound, and about half an assist per game. And I understand why off the start, those numbers aren't really going to stand out to you. But at the same time, I do think that Florida this year would be at their best with a natural ball distributor like Glover, who lets guys like Locke, guys like Lewis, and guys like Keontae Johnson make plays on the wing. I think Trey Mann, along with Tyree Appleby, the Cleveland State transfer, and Anthony DeRuggi, the Louisiana Tech transfer, those are going to be the guys that really make up this Florida Gator bench, and I do think it's going to be very important for Mike White and the rest of these players to really buy into their role. And given the history of Florida and what they've done over the last couple of years under Mike White, I just am not necessarily sure that I could fully buy in to that happening.